Hey, Jen, yeah. Back to the drone strike. You said last month, our over-the-horizon capacity can work and has worked in going after ISIS targets and killing people who went after our troops, but you guys didn't kill people who went after our troops. You killed 10 civilians, including 7 children. So does the president still think these over-the-horizon strikes can work?
Absolutely, and I will just reiterate, as our Secretary of Defense conveyed, as General McKenzie conveyed, that there was a serious mistake. The Secretary of Defense has authorized, as I noted before, a thorough review of the investigation just completed by U.S. Central Command, including the degree to which the investigation considered all available context and information, the degree to which accountability measures need to be taken, at which level, and the degree to which strike authorities' procedures and processes need to be altered in the future. That's an important process. I would note, which I noted earlier, that there's a difference between a self-defense strike, which is exactly what this was, and I would note there was one prior to this that was a successful self-defense strike, and those that is posing an imminent threat to U.S. forces, who were, as we all know, on the ground at that time, facing real threats in real time, and an over-the-horizon strike, where we typically expect to have more time to assess both the threat and the potential target. That is a different approach, and it requires a different approach, and is a different approach internally, and General McKenzie spoke to that last week as well.
Some of the victims' relatives are saying that they want to be relocated here. Is that something that the administration is going to help them do?
I'm not aware of that request, that ask. I'm happy to certainly speak to our national security team and see what that process will look like.
A question about what's going on at the border. Is somebody asking the foreign nationals who are walking into Del Rio, Texas, and setting up camps on this side of the border for proof of vaccination or a negative COVID test?
Well, first of all, I can readdress for you or re-talk you through what steps we take.
That is the policy for people who fly into the country. So if somebody walks into the country right across the river, does somebody ask them to see their vaccination card?
Well, let me explain to you again, Peter, how our process works. As individuals come across the border, they are both assessed for whether they have any symptoms. If they have symptoms, the intention is for them to be quarantined. That is our process. They're not intending to stay here for a lengthy period of time. I don't think it's
the
same thing.
It's
not the same thing. These are individuals, as we've noted and as we've been discussed, we are expelling individuals based on Title 42. Specifically because of COVID, because we want to prevent a scenario where large numbers of people are gathering, posing a threat to the community and also to the migrants themselves. So those are the policies that we put in place, in large part because, again, the CDC continues to recommend Title 42 be in place, given we're facing a global pandemic.
Where's the Vice President on any of this? Isn't she supposed to be addressing the root causes of migration?
Absolutely, and she has been addressing the root causes of migration by working with countries in the region to ensure they have the assistance they need to reduce the number of people who are coming and trying to make those journeys across the border. We've actually seen some reductions in some of those numbers. That doesn't change the fact that this is a very challenging situation in Del Rio. We're working to implement our policies, and we're working to ensure we are also addressing root causes.
Just a quick one on boosters. Why did the president say in August, just remember as a simple rule, 8 months after your second shot, get a booster shot if there is not enough data to support that for the general population?
Well, what the president also said is that I want to be very clear. The plan is pending the FDA conducting an independent evaluation of the safety and effectiveness of a third dose of the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines and the CDC's advisory committee. We are right now in the week of September 20th. The advisory committee is meeting on Thursday. We've seen some recommendations that we felt was a step forward in providing more protection to people across the country, and we'll wait for that process to play out. Our objective and our role is to ensure we have the capacity, the number of shots to provide them to the American people.
16 out of 18 FDA advisors say there is not the science. The president talks about following the science. Is this a case of him getting ahead of the science?
Well, first of all, I think what you heard Dr. Collins and Dr. Fauci convey yesterday is that this is going to be an ongoing process. I would remind you that the percentage of individuals at this point who would be eligible to get a booster are largely people over 65, because those are people who would have had the second dose 6 months ago. If we're looking at when we're going to have available data, that's what the CDC and the FDA looks at. They need enough data to make assessments. No one is suggesting that there will never be boosters. We are suggesting that there needs to be a process to be seen through for when boosters should be approved and when a broader swath of the population is eligible.